Hi, I'm Andrew from AWS.
I'm Andrew from Draw Wireless. This is my architecture.
So thank you for being on the show, Andrew. At Drop Wireless, what do you guys do and what business problem are you trying to solve using this architecture on AWS?
So our main mission is to building community-based wireless network. Our focus is really provide compelling and innovative use cases. And one example is what we're going to talk about today, which is indoor positioning, combining two unique wireless technology.
Okay. So what's the setting?
So these two technologies, the first one is called UWB, Ultra Wideband.
Okay.
And then the second technology is called LoRa, Long Range.
LoRa, okay.
And first, there are three elements, hardware elements involved. There's the UWB anchors, say A1, A2, and A3. And then there's a tag that combines these two technologies, UWB and LoRa.
I see.
And the way the system works is the tag basically sends a signal to each anchor and measures the round trip timing. And then we convert to the timing to distance information.
I see.
D1, D2, and D3.
I see. So you said these are hardware devices. They're positioned in, say, a factory, and the anchors are located at certain positions. The tag is also a hardware device, is that correct? And you say you capture the positioning of these, the distance to this tag?
Correct.
Okay. I see. And then you said you're capturing this. How do you capture this data?
We capture this data into what's called the LoRa packet.
Okay.
And then once they're encapsulated in LoRa packet, sent over this LoRa protocol over the air, and there's a LoRa gateway that receives this packet, and then the packet gets sent over to AWS IoT Core for LoRaWAN through internet.
Oh, so you have a wireless connectivity with the gateway, okay, and use IoT Core for LoRaWAN to capture these packets.
Correct.
Okay, and what's inside the packet?
At this point, you have D1, D2, D3, the distance data with the timestamp.
Okay.
So this distance data with the specific time instance.
So now we capture this information. We have the packets with the distance data. I see Lambda. What's the function of Lambda?
So from AWS IoT Core for LoRaWAN, what you have is this decrypted payload data, which still contains D1, D2, D3, but they're in machine readable format called the base 64. So we do need to convert this to something that we can analyze. So going from machine readable to human readable through Lambda service.
Okay, so you do that with the Lambda.
Correct.
And then once you have it in a human readable format, do you pass it on to EC2? What's the function of EC2?
That's where our location processing engine runs on EC2.
Okay.
And the ultimate goal of this indoor positioning is to be able to extract XYZ information, the specific location of the tag at certain time instance.
So you calculate that using
right.
a series of a fleet of EC2s. I see, the right. positioning.
Sure.
And then, so I see MQTT protocol. What's the function of that?
So here comes XYZ with the timestamp. And then we publish it on MQTT service and to a certain topic. And that allows other services be able to subscribe it and use the data.
Let's dial into or zoom in on those specific services that are consuming data from the MQTT.
One that's really worth mentioning is the using machine learning to augment the positioning capability. We mathematically computed XYZ on EC2, and now machine learning is really helping to really hone
in. I see. And that's not projected here on the screen,
correct.
But there's another
right.
component to that. And then what about Aurora?
So this data, once you have it over time, can really use for improving the manufacturing efficiency, So you want to use for the data analysis.
Okay.
And we have the database running on Aurora.
Oh, so you capture this and store right. it, Correct. Retain this information yeah. in Aurora. Is this a batch process? Is it real time? How do you capture this information?
As most of the IoT system, this is all running in real time. Mm. And UWB itself can send up to distance information 10 times per second.
Oh, wow.
And then we aggregate it and send it over LoRa up to one time per second.
And as a consumer of this technology, what benefits do they get?
Our initial customer is they manufacture very small, crafty, high-value items and easy to get lost in the manufacturing process. By attaching this UWB tag, they can track where they are and find in a relatively large space. So it has immediate benefit to this manufacturing environment.
Wonderful. Andrew, thank you so much for walking us through this architecture. It's really a great use case.
Thanks for having me.